Testing. Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you so much for coming. We will be starting shortly, so if you're not seated yet, please find a seat. Thank you.
Thank you.
in our hurtings, in our weakness, in our storms, and in our sorrows. And in the night seasons of our soul, we come to the place where we need to pray. Precious Lord, take my hand.
There are two things that happen in every life on this earth. One is we have to be born. Second, we have to die. Shall we all rise for prayer? O most gracious, loving Father in heaven, our mighty and powerful God, Creator of the universe, you are kind, compassionate, forgiving, and loving. Father, thank you for the gift of life. Thank you, Lord, for providing us all the things we need and thank you for your Son, who died for our sins, so that through him we'll have hope and everlasting life. Father, I pray for thy holy presence as we celebrate the life of Manong Bibot. We cling, O Lord, to thy promise that we will see him again in your second coming. I pray for peace and comfort, O Lord, for Manang Lisa, Jinky, Jingle, Ritzie, and the rest of the Quinones family. Father, thank you for the love to all of us. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Please be seated. Good afternoon, everyone. On behalf of the family of Manong Bibot and the rest of the Quinones clan, I welcome everyone to the celebration of Manong Bibot's life. Your presence manifests you care. Let us remember Manong Bibot as a happy person, full of life, caring and loving husband, father, grandpa, a brother, and a friend. Of course, we mourn for his passing. But let us be comforted to the promise in John 14, verses 1-3. And I quote, "If you believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's kingdom, there are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I will go and prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again to receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also." Family and friends, let us cling to the promise that if we dwell with the Lord, we will be with him during his second coming. Thank you.
Constant friend is he. I know every one of us today feel very sad of passing away our beloved brother, Bibot Quiñones. I have known him long time ago when I was the pastor of Waterman Visayan Filipino Seventh-day Adventist Church. I feel like my brother. The fact that he knows my family tree from Pikit, Cotubado. He was the school superintendent of the whole Cotubado at that time. It was not divided yet. And the last time that we met in this church was the foot washing of the last quarter of the year 2015, when he as a visitor introduced me in that side and we talked for a quite a time. And that was the last time I saw him. I know how hard and sad to see a loved one pass away. Actually, in my life, I experienced sadness for passing away of my beloved mother when a father when I was 10 years old. That was in the year 1952, long time ago. My third brother passed away in Chicago in the year 2001 after we visited the Philippines. After 2 months in the U.S., after our vacation, he stayed here long, long time ago. He came to America in the year 1969, and he died in the year 2001. Next that passed away was my beloved mother in the year 2007 in Davao City. Then the third one that passed away was my older brother, the same year, in the year 2007, in our college in Managa, Digos, Davao. And the fourth that passed away was my second oldest brother. Just 3 years ago. I'm the only one left in our family. But still, as the song says, the eyes of God is on the sparrow. How much more for us, my beloved friends? How much more for us? According to Isaiah, if you suffer, Jesus suffered also with you. That is the assurance, my beloved, that I am safe. We are safe in the arms of God, my beloved. Your sadness is nothing if you trust in God. The assurance that God gave us, my beloved, is written in the book of 1 Peter 5, verse 7. Cast all your anxiety or cast all your sorrows upon Him, to Jesus Christ, for what? He cares for you and for me. To everyone. That is how the Lord is good. John 3:16. For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish, but what? Have everlasting life. Think about the offer of Jesus Christ, my beloved. Everlasting life. No more death. No more sorrow. No more separation. Death is swallowed up. We will enjoy eternal life. Today, my beloved, we suffer. The greatest enemy that we have is death. If cancer will come to you, the scientist did not find a solution yet in medicine to conquer the germ cells that is in our body. I'm glad to announce to you this morning, this noon, that one or the second disease that it's hard to overcome is the Alzheimer, but we find already a solution, a medicine. I just read the other day that medicine could protect our brain, that it will not be injected by that Alzheimer's disease and could survive our memory. That is the power of science, my beloved friends. But there is more powerful than the scientists, my beloved. It is our beloved Lord Jesus Christ. Casting all your care upon him, for he cares for you. Could we see here the unspeakable love of God to man? When Peter says, cast your care upon him, could we see? Yes. The love of God lies behind the darkest experience of his life on Calvary. He passed this experience that we have, my beloved. Because the first man on earth, Adam, gave us all this trouble, heartaches in this world. But we are glad that there is a man, that is Jesus Christ, who solved the problem of this world because of dying on the cross. What a gift from heaven that was given to this planet, the blood of Jesus Christ. There on the cross was demonstrated the undying love of God. There on the cross was where the unspeakable love of God shined its brightest color, that he died for you and me. There on the cross, he promised to that one man who is a criminal, thou shalt be with me in paradise. How much more for us, my beloved, who believe on him? How much more for you who trust in him? You will be where able I will be, he promised in John 3:16, and you will live with me forever. Take that into your heart, my beloved. It's not a promise of man, but it was a promise of our Lord Jesus Christ that you will be with me in paradise. There on the cross was where we are able to see God's everlasting love, even behind the sorrows of life, even behind pain, even behind sickness and death. There is the love of God. That was also the reason why Job saw his loving God behind his darkest experience in life. That was also the reason why Mary and Martha developed their trust in God after the death of their beloved brother. And he was resurrected by the Lord, their beloved brother. And God shouted, Lazarus, come forth. And because of that power of love, the power of God in him, he was able to resurrect Lazarus from the grave. Not from heaven. Not from heaven, my beloved, because people today believe that when a man dies, he goes direct to heaven. That is the belief of some people today. But no, sir. When you die, you go back to the dust where we come from until Jesus Christ will come and bring us life. That is what the Bible says. Don't believe if people tell you that the people who died, they go direct to heaven. That is wrong. You cannot find in the words of God, my beloved. David said that even their memory is not working. And even he himself is still in the grave, waiting for the coming of the Lord. Casting all your cares upon him, for he cares for you. Could we see God, consolation and assurances? Can we, in the hour of great sorrow, trust in a loving God? Could we leave our burden to him? Could we free our mind from sorrow, my beloved, who are directly connected with Brother Bibot? I challenge you this afternoon. Trust in God. Believe on him. And he will give you comfort. In the book of Isaiah 63, 7 and 9, let me tell you of the kindness of the Lord and the other deeds for which he should be praised. Just think of all the Lord has done for you. Think it over again, my friends. We are here today happy. We have money. We have cars, we have houses, we are in good health. Then sometimes we could not think of him who is giving us all these kind of blessings. And yet sometimes we fight each other, even in the family, even in the church. But please remember, Jesus is the one who is giving you life. Not anybody. I just talked to somebody while I'm coming this way. That's why I'm late a little bit. He has a big property. Beautiful house, big house on acres of land. But the man told me, the owner of that property, sir, pass away. He cannot do anything. It's a beautiful location here. His house is so beautiful and big and wide. But where he is, he's down 6 feet below the ground. Don't trust in your wealth, my beloved. Don't trust in your health. Don't trust in your mind, because you are wise and smart. You think that everything is okay. No, sir. Trust in God. Believe in him, because he's the one direct your own way. The question today, could death separate us from the love of God? Now that Brother Bibot passed away, the direct family and friends and members of this church, will that separate you from the love of God? Do you question why did the Lord take the life of my beloved Brother Bibot? Will not come that into your mind? Sometimes my mind is bothered. I just come across to my Bible. Which challenged me so much that I don't know where to go unless I have to go to Jesus. The Bible says, I love Jacob and hate Esau. Do you believe that? That it is in the Bible? I ask myself, if the Lord today will say, I hate Bugayong and I love Quiñones, is that an unfair? Is that fair? Think it over, my beloved. Think it over. Because John 15, 16 says, you have not chosen me, but what? I have chosen you. I was shocked, my beloved. I've been reading Genesis to Revelation how many times, but I was struck by that verse when I read in the book of Romans, my beloved, that I love Jacob and I hate Esau. When these two guys was still in that womb of their mom, the angel of the Lord predicted that what is in your womb today is a too great nation, but the younger will be the one to lead the older. And then it continues, because I love Jacob and I hate Esau. I said to myself, is the Lord fair? Lord will tell me, I love Leah, but I hate you, host. I think my brain will expand in how many pounds to think. Why, Lord? Why you love somebody and you hate me? Then I came to realize, my beloved, that the word so, S-O, is a wonderful word. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him will not die, but have everlasting. There, I hope, he will bring me home when he comes. All of us, my beloved, all of us, because he promised to Jacob, I will save Israel, you, me, if we trust in him. Beloved, trust him. Believe him. Have faith in God. Have faith in God. He is a merciful, a loving God. Today, there may be sadness in our hearts for passing away of Brother Bebop. But one day, there will be a rejoicing that will never end, my beloved. Today, there may be suffering, but one day soon, there will be no more pain. Today, we feel the void caused by death. But beyond there awaits for us the crown of life, which the Lord will give to all those who love his appearing. Family and friends, I would like to read this book of Isaiah 41, verse 10. Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee, yea, I will help thee. I will hold thee with my right hand of my righteousness. Oh, what a promise, my beloved. What a promise. The blessed and glorious promise of God is found in John 11, 25 and 26. I am the resurrection and the life. Well, beloved, there is death. But if there is no resurrection, our faith is nothing. But we are glad. We are glad that God promised to us, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live again. Brother Bebot, although he is dead. But the promise of God, he will live again. And whosoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Oh, what a promise. What a promise, my beloved. We are assured everything that will bring us comfort in the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. Resurrection morning will give us hope, my beloved. Resurrection morning brings eternal liberty to the saints. Resurrection morning will bring liberty for our enemies. Resurrection morning brings liberty from all uncertainties that makes the life difficult. Resurrection morning will reunite our loved ones that had been separated by death. Resurrection morning will give us the privilege to meet Adam and Eve and the saints of all ages. Someday soon, we'll begin to hear the trumpet sound and the angels will shout, Alleluia, salvation, glory, honor, and power belong to the Lord our God. Someday soon, family and friends, Brother Bebot will be among those who will look up and exclaim, Lo, this is our God. We have waited for him, and he will save us. What a comfort, my beloved. You and me will shout together with Brother Bebot. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. Don't you want to be there? When we are united with our loved ones, never to part again, and walk together down the streets of gold to the tree of life, what a day that will be. In his glory, we shall see the King. And forever let his praises sing. For on Calvary, Jesus died for all of us. That's why we want to see the King someday. Blessed Brother Bebot, who died in the Lord. To close, I have a poem dedicated to the family and friends. Sleep on, Brother Bebot, beloved. Sleep and take thy rest. So love thee well, but Jesus loved thee best. Sleep on, my beloved. Good night. Come is thy slumber as an infant sleep. Thou shalt wake no more to toil and wept. Thine is a perfect rest, secure and depth. Sleep on, Brother Bebot, sleep on, our beloved brother, and good night. Until the shadow from the earth cast until he gathers his shapes at last, until twilight gloom is overpast, sleep on, my beloved, and good night. Only good night, not farewell, brother Bebot. A little while, and all his sons and daughters shall dwell in hallowed union indivisible. Good night, good night, but not farewell. God bless you, and bless everybody. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor, for that nice message. Manong Bibot was, he loves to sing karaoke in my house every time we get together. And this song that I'm about to sing is, we used to sing this, four of us brothers, but now he's gone, and Dodong is in the Philippines. So this is one of his favorite songs. It's called "You'll Never Walk Alone."
When you walk through a storm, hold your head up high and don't be afraid of the dark. At the end to go. Your dreams be
you. At this time, I'd like to call on a couple of family members and share some of their memories about my beloved brother. I'm going to start off with a nephew, Ron Lau. You know, y'all know his mom, my sister Sally, passed away just 2 years ago. And Ron's going to share some memories with us.
Hi. It's just kind of weird being back here. I haven't been back here since my mom, and it's just weird because it's, you know, same month of March, just 2 years earlier. But my Uncle Bebot was a very funny guy. Told me a lot of jokes. Most of them I can't say now. But what I do remember from him is that we'd be playing tennis, and the whole time, to try to distract you, he'd be telling you jokes. And like, if you hit a good shot and it was in, but he wasn't there to get it, he'd call it out. I'm like, what are you talking about? It was in. No, it's out of reach. So it's stuff like that that, you know, it gets me, and it just breaks my heart, just, you know, just seeing him, it's just, I remember all the life that he had. I just remember the energy and just enthusiasm, just the effort to make you laugh. You know, he was the life of our family party. I mean, Grant, you know, everyone here could sing. Our family, they'd sing. I couldn't sing. I just sat down and listened. But I think the one trait I did get that came through the lines for him was, at least I tried to be funny. You know, for him it was natural. But yeah, I just remember those times at family parties and just playing tennis with him. I mean, I'm going to really miss those times. So, I don't know. I mean, there's just so much emotion going on, and I'm just thankful that, you know, that we are so able to, you know, come together as a family and just to celebrate the impact he's had on our lives. So, all right.
Of course, Manong Bibot has a lot of jokes, but a true experience also. In the 80s, I have a Citation car, and he was driving Innova. I took my car to Sears for service, so I requested him to pick me up. On his way, he was stopped by a police officer, and I believe he only heard about, I'll give you a citation. Maybe he heard only the word citation. And what he said, no officer, this is Nova. This is not citation. So, another thing way back in the early 80s also, we were camping somewhere in San Clemente, and they came late, and the gate was already closed, but there was a security guard. So what he did, he speak in our dialect, and the security guard, of course, won't understand him, so they let him in. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Hazel. I'm his niece. My uncle and I had an ongoing joke that we would call each other twins because we shared the same birthday, December 19th. And every time I saw him, it was, hey, twin! Hey, twin! So, and sometimes we would celebrate our birthdays together, the last one we were together. And so I was fortunate to take a picture of him. He was definitely a funny guy. I think I got a little bit of that trait. If you see, that's me and my uncle always this. So we have that in common, and also our love of music. He definitely was the life of the party, always entered a room singing and dancing. Happy Thanksgiving to you is always something, or an Engel Humperdinck tune. But I think if he could sing one more great love song, I think he would sing this one. That's just typical. Definitely would happen to Uncle B-Butt. Totally. But he would keep singing. See, he likes the good old days when there were cassette players and CDs. Now we have these things that plug in your phone, and what if somebody calls while you're singing on your phone? Oh gosh.
Wise men say only fools rush in. But I can't help falling in love with you. Shall I stay? Would it be a sin if like a river flows surely to the sea, darling, so it goes. Some things are meant to be. Take my hand, take my whole life too. But I can't help falling in love with you. Like a river flows surely to the sea, darling, so it goes. Some things were meant to be. Take my hand, take my whole life too, for I can't help falling in love with you.
Hello. Thank you for coming. I'm pretty sure my papa would have appreciated it. For those who don't know, my name is Richie Quinones. I am the grandchild of Bibot. December 19, 1947, Bibot Quinones was born. He was the first son, third child of Bibiano and Juanita Quinones. My papa was born in Crossing Bual, Midsayap, Philippines. He went to school in Southern Christian College in Midsayap, right there along the main road over there. I don't know much about my papa's childhood, but he did always tell me he was always sorosoroy, the way he called it, looking. Very, very adventurous man he was. He once told me a story when he was about 16 years old. He said he got a fake license so he can become a truck driver. So that's what he did most of his life since around that age. He told me he would drive logging trucks, tankers, all over Philippines. In 1968, he was driving for my Uncle Yana and Auntie Shirley's livestock business, transporting livestock from Cotabato to Cagayan, all over Mindanao. That's the same year where he met my mama, Elisa. My mama was a... She worked in a restaurant for her parents. Her and her sisters were my papa and his cousins, Rudy, Uncle Julie, Uncle Bibbs, where they would all hang out there and drink beer and stuff after work. That's where he met my mama. And shortly after that, they were married the next year in 1969. In 1970, they gave birth to my mom, Jinky. Apparently, they were born in the same house. That's what I was told. In the next few years, they moved from Cotabato to Cebu. And they were moving around there. Papa was still a truck driver. Moving back and forth from Cebu to Cotabato to Libungan. In 1973 is when apparently Grandma petitioned my papa, Auntie Nine, and Uncle Duroy to come to America or Hawaii to be with the rest of the family. Unfortunately, Papa was already married to my mama and had my mom, so they had to wait. They had to wait in the Philippines for maybe about 9-10 years. In 1978, that's when Jingle was born in Cebu. They moved back to Libungan, sold a couple of their jeepneys to move back there. That's where Mama's family was and some of their cousins. After that, they got word that they can come here to America where the rest of the family was in 1983. So they sold the house, they sold the jeepneys, and they came here to be with everyone else. Later on in the 80s, 1988, that's when I was born. I am, like I said, I'm the only grandchild of Papa Bibot. Since I've known my papa, he was always laughing and joking around like everyone said. He was always singing karaoke. Sometimes I would be waking up at 6:30 in the morning of him singing karaoke. I would get so mad at him. Pa, I have to go to school. Let me sleep one more hour. And then you'd just hear his voice in the microphone. Wake up now, boy. It's time to eat. He loved to play tennis every Sunday he was here. When he was home from the road, He had many friends that he played tennis with. Pastor Trasporte was one of them that played. He always loved to go fishing with Grandpa, fishing in Uncle Duroy's boat. He was always the life of the party, always happy. Some of my favorite memories I have with my papa was going with him in his truck. I remember one time when I was maybe around 9 or 10, I went with him. I was gone for about 3 weeks. We went to Texas, we even went to North Carolina, visited Auntie Nini, Auntie Shirley. One time we visited Auntie Bibi and Uncle Matt when they were living in San Jose. Hunter was still maybe only 1 or 2 years old at that time. My papa taught me a lot of things, but the most important thing he taught me was to always be calm and relax. Don't take things too serious. Always be happy. I always remember him with a big smile on his face, always cracking jokes, and I'm sure if he was here, he would tell us many jokes to lighten the mood. I'm just glad that my papa's no longer suffering. He was struggling for a while. And Jesus took him, so he's no longer suffering. And I know one day we'll all be there and see my papa again. I can't wait for that day to come, to see my papa, Auntie Sally, and Grandpa again. I'm sure we will all be very happy when that day comes. My Papa, you are very loved. Everyone here loves you. Thank you.
Praises to Christ, our King.
Thank you, Novem. I'd like to call on Ning Aton to come and share some memories you have of our brother.
Hello, both. Bibot, as he is fondly called by relatives, friends in Midsayap, and in the Philippines overall. But Eli calls him Migo Sano Bay. We had a lot of memories with Bibot when he was still in the Philippines. Bibot is the joker type. If he is around in the group, sadya gyud kaayo. You mean sadya? Who does not understand sadya? All is happy. So the tennis club of Midsayap just relayed their message that they miss Bibot very much, especially Congressman Sakdalan Liz, you know him. In our younger days in Buwal, they are all small, and I think they could still remember what's happening with June Quinones there. I could not relate, but we just gather it. Someone will die, someone will be married, and wedding and baptism. We are a lot of relatives. The Quinones multiply fast. It can be seen in Bibot. Nang mamanits, they are 11 and the family. I don't know why she did not have the family planning. When Bibot was driving his tanker in Libungan, they just parked at the back of our house in Lucila's village. So over, no fence, he would just call Ellie right away, drinking beer, tuba, beer. Then they will grill or sugba haluan. So that's their delicacy. So I will just call him, Bot, dali na Bot, kaon na ta, kasab anak pud kang Lisa ron. I'm calling him to come over and eat because they just drink and drink without rice. That's what they're doing. Then I did not know that Bibot was operated, we were in the Philippines, and we just know he was doing well. We were really very happy with him. When we came over to America, almost every happening in Loma Linda, our faces are there, because we were really close in the Philippines. The Quiñones group, even though they are already American citizens, they treated us Filipino citizens very well. And when Bibot was not feeling all right now, but still he can drive, he always goes to Lake Elsinore, the place where my daughter is staying. He loves to have that lauoy. I don't know if you know that, that pure veggie menu with fried fish or what. That's what he likes, because my son-in-law has a nice vegetable garden there. So Lisa will pick up some vegetables, then Ellie will cook, and Bibot will sit there. Jokes, you know their jokes. We'll not tell them anymore, dino? We'll just give you a hint, kanang mga kuyos. I don't know what's kuyos there. What else? What are your jokes? We will not say it, but we will just say when we will be together, not here. And last, he stopped going to the house last December, and the last time when Edna and Olan came to the house, they just called us that they will have their lunch there, so we prepared. After that, he was not able to go there anymore because Lisa was telling me, mura nagyugluya si Bibot Ning. I had a follow-up of his situation. He's losing of pounds, his permanent oxygen in his nose. I was even saying, but do not place that oxygen there. Siya nga naman, dili makita ang pagkamistiso sa imong ilong, taas ra baka kaig ilong. I said he was having a high nose. So he removes it. Edna has seen, he removed that oxygen. Was that? I don't know that, Ed. Then he walked to the restroom. Last Friday, Lisa called. She told me, Ning, murag si Bibot, luya na gyud. He's already sick. I said, he said, anhi mo ni Eli. I said, let us just pray, Liz, because, you know, we are not drivers. We have no cars. So we have to depend on our children's free time. Kung bakante akong anak, we can go. But Saturday is always our weekend. But we have no work, huh? Weekend lang. Weekend off. So we can go any place. So we decided to go there last Saturday. When I saw Bibot, I don't say to a sick man nga, uy, luoy man ka. No, do not say that. Because he will feel more depressed. So I look at him. Uy, pink man lagi ang imo aping but siya luya na gyud ning isa na lang kawati ang wala mo perma inako ay naglaag-laag pa man tong wati. Then he laughed, then he said, le hiluta ko massage. So when Ellie massages his back and his chest, he said, oh, I hope you will stay here because I'm feeling good. And in the afternoon, while the sisters were there, we had a nice dinner with vegetables, Benignit, and Shakoy. Shakoy was the next day. He asked Benignit from Ellie. So Jinky was having a bowl of Benignit. He gave it to Ellie. He ate it. Because Lisa said, I said, but you toothbrush your tongue. Maybe you have no appetite. But really, I knew. Because when Lisa said that he lost already 10 pounds, that is really a sign of the cancer, that it is really moving fast, because his mother died of cancer and the doctor told us that if you will not have appetite, that is the time you will be taken by the Lord. But we don't give him any discouragement. He walks, he talks, they share jokes. Then the next day, Lisa and Ellie went to, what's that, Staters. They bought groceries and bottled water. So I talked to him. I put my arms on his shoulder. I said, how do you feel? He said, I'm really very tired. I said, are you ready? Yes, I'm ready. Did you ask forgiveness? Yes. Did you forgive others? Yes, everything, he said. But he did not feel depressed. He was really strong. I know he was strong for his family because he was always telling me that he looks back at Lisa and the children, but now the children have done their best to make their papa happy. So the next day we were bound for home. He said, do not go home. I said, no, we will go home because we have a lot of work to do and Ivy will be fetching us. For the last time, he told Ellie to massage him. He said, I can sleep now soundly. So de, wala na gid si Bibot. Wa na joke-joke ha? Wala na bay. We go, sano. And we are just happy, thankful to God that he has rested in a deep sleep. We will be back together in the coming of our Lord. So thank you everybody for making us a part of this celebration. Maing hapon.
Thank you so much. I'd like to maybe call on one more person to share memories. Uncle Baludoy. Or like disco-disco, ha? Kay kuan.
Mayang hapon, tanan. Pamina ko, murag nakailan naman mo kanako. Katungwa mo kaila, problema na na ninyo. Si Bibot, akong pag-umangkon sa mag-agawan. Igagawan ako ang yang inahan o pag-umangkon ako yang anak. Akong mahinumduman si Bibot, atong ibalik sa, sa Pilipinas for 40 years ago. Kini si Bibot, nagbiyahe ni siya, kaduna ni siya jeep. Kada adlaw magbiyahe o niya kung mahapunan po ko, ato na lang po ko silang Bibot mo higda, na libre ko kaon, libre katulog na Lisa. Mayo, magkanyang pamilya, mga buutan ni sila kayo. Kini sila si Lisa o si Bibot sa Pilipinas. Hayahay pa na sila sa polis. Kay maayo man lang kahimtang. Kaya kanya itong mga panahon na ang sweldo sa tao, 4 pesos a day, 120 pesos a month. Pero si Bibot, makita ang nag-utsinta. Kada adlaw sa jeep, mugarahin na nagsayo. Por iso, kayahay na po ko dito. O sa kay gayon, atol nga na ako'y dahan trabaho, kanang kabinet, dili makaabri ang mga tresurero, ang ilang bolt door, dili sila makaabli na. Ako nilang paabli ana unya wa mo kasakyan si Bibot ako siyang yang ngabot kanang akrihan na ko imong jeep ug cinta libre na tanan sa o moto nga amo to gikarga kay mga kuan man to bukat man to ko ayo mga kabinet kay putang namo dito mo na ang ka kuan ko ni Bibot nga gikan adto ambot pila ka adlaw tolo bato ka adlaw imong kubot kanang ato lang ito, takurong. Hapito na ito sa pagkawayan itong typewriter kay ipaayom ako na ito sa miyar mo. Ito nga, lihatod ko ni Bibot, na ito na ito sa kutabato, mingaw na baka ayong agyanan kay mga muklo, mga agyanan dito. Pero lihatod ko ni Bibot, muna ang kinabuhi, Bibot, para sa ako ah. Kay, ambot, di naman ito silisa itong pag-atong na ako dito sa ilang ah. Anong gabi? Hoy, utangan kang Bibot, ay! Huwag kakabayad, ha? Uyawan, anak maningil, may Bibot na kong magabi. Ayaw ba ako kita, but abin ni mo tinood, waiting list naman ko. Kaysa tanan din ni Mro, makakun na rin, doon ay cancer. Uyaw, kaning cancer, lipinting, lisura, ani, oy. Si Lisa, makaagwanta ka, magtanaw ni Bibot nga. Kahit po kayo ang asawa, oy, magtanaw sa imong asawa. Bana ni mo nga, mura may mga ako na lang usana. Eh, pwede man yung paita. Pero pasalamatan ni Lisa nga, gikan ka nito hangtod nga, nabugto yung kabi, si Lisa, nagyod pirmi sa iyang likiran. Dini sa Amerika, ako pa ipatrabaho ni Bibot sa ambalay sa Kural, bisag dili ko maayo. Pero di mapod kayo, tanaw ni mo, dili lang kayo, tanaw, maayo, aro mo magtuntung Kural dito tanaw. Nga mga nang masalaag naman yung tawag, hain, tumbalay ni Bibot, nagikural na nako. O din eh, si Sally, ako o si Bibot, kami ang entertainer sa mga sabadista sa simbahan. Sayo mi bisa konsa na magtangko-tangko mis bibot sa sari. Karon na mawala nila duha. Ako na lang sara. Ang puwitin yung pukuan eh. Pero yung ako bot, dito ta maghusay sa akong utang. Sa guha man kung nakukubayad. Joke lang. Muna nga, din sa Amerika, hayahay mo po na, kung dito pa kasi Pinas, duwera, so may bayad na ako ng doktor nga, kada bulan, bayrani mo na, radyasyon. Kanina doon, kung katong na nabako, kung muundang na mo, sakit ninyo, maabot pa magkutsinta bago doon ay sakit, pero kung di mo muundang, ah, wala pa may sasinta, masakit no, cancer. Mas maay pa muundang karon, kung wala mo manigil, ayaw na lang yun. Karon, no? Magliso na mga ganito, sunod siguro ko ani, di magrugay. Kung na magandam-andam saan mo nga, ang limos. Sige, salamat.
Thank you. Joker. Okay, Matt, come.
Thank you, Maddie. Before I sing, I want to share a couple of things. First, you know, my brother was a truck driver. We all know that. And sometimes during Christmas, it'd be like he'd come to the Christmas parties and it'd be like Santa Claus, because sometimes there would be a box left in the truck. And one year, like, he had like Barbasol, the shaving cream, you know, and like toothbrushes. And like, I remember when Mentadent came out, I don't know if you guys remember that, but it was the new toothpaste, like instead of a tube, you push it, and he had like a box full of that, so he gave that away. That was so cool because, you know, it wasn't really affordable because it's expensive, right? Remember that? So anyway, and also I know that somebody will be, I have to share this. It's been in our family for so long, but one of Manong's nieces, her name is Jing. She will never, never, ever know the truth about this. But once, a long, long time ago in Cebu, I guess they lived together or something, but anyway, they had breakfast together, Manong and Jing and their siblings. And I guess Manong, I don't know what, if you know what alap-up is, you know, it's that white stuff that you get from like the sun or like it was like some sort of bacteria or something, Jing. Is bacteria. And anyway, so they were eating breakfast, and I guess they had pancakes. And Manong, the jokester that he was, knowing that Jing is so delicada, very delicada, which means she's so, you know, like so arty or like, ew, eek, you know, germaphobe or whatever. I guess she left the room for, I don't know the right way to tell the story, but she left the room, and when she came back to for her pancakes, Manong said, Jing, you better not eat that because I put it in my kili-kili. You know, I rubbed the pancake on my kili-kili, and then with the alap-up, Jing's like, no, don't, I want to eat the pancakes or something like that, right? But now for years, been asking Manong, is it true? Did I really eat the pancakes with your kili-kili and the alap-up? You know, so now I guess we'll never know. He took it to his grave, literally, right? Anyway, the song that I'm going to sing to close the program is In My Life, and we're going to show a slideshow. Can I just have asked for the lights to be turned on so we can all see it, please? Have a better view of the slideshow. And I'm just going to sit here so you can concentrate on that. And my son Hunter is going to accompany me.
With you and these men.
is something new. Though I know I'll never lose affection for people and things that went before, I know I'll often stop and think about them. In my life, I love you more. People and things that went before, I know I'll often stop and think about them. In my life, I loved you more. There are places I remember all my life, though some have changed, some forever, not for better. Some have gone and some remain. All these places have their moments. With brothers and friends, I still can recall. Some are dead and some are living. In my life, I've loved them. Thank you.
once my mom told me a story of Uncle Bebo. It was near it was Christmas Eve, and most of our family was already at the house that we were having Christmas Eve at. Uncle Bebo walked into the wrong house and then said, "Merry Christmas." And then he was holding some type of food, and then the people that were celebrating Christmas there said, "Okay, we'll take the food." And then after, as soon as he walked out, I was thinking that he may have thought, why did I walk into the wrong house?
Because he's Bebo, that's why.
Thank you, Mari. Well, this is not in the program, but let me just do a little justice on my brother Bebo here. All you guys know that he's a joker. He's fun. He cracked a lot of worthy jokes, unworthy jokes, or whatever jokes. He's a good singer and all that. But to me, I grew up with this guy. You know, and to me, I know I told Jinky I wouldn't do this, but to me, he's my guardian angel. To me, he's my Cupid brother. Just to roll back, when I was 14 years old, we attended a fiesta party in Midsayap, crossing Midsayap with my cousin, Pedro Quinones. And this cousin of mine is just something else. He create and make troubles all the time. And it so happened that I was with him that day. And all of a sudden, we were in a back corner of that little barrio there with six tall, big thugs, you know, bugoys. We call them bugoys. And they have machetes and big knives. And I don't know, I said, this must be the end of me, because they were so angry at us because that cousin of mine talked to that girl in the fiesta party that happens to be the other guy that was a thug, I say. It's a suitor of that girl there. But anyway, so I don't know how to fight, but I fought these four guys plus the other, but we are outnumbered. And I said, this got to be the end of us. Mercy, I says. All of a sudden, a big truck stop, and here comes Bebo with a big stick. I don't know where he come from. I don't know, but that saves not only our day, but my life. So to me, he was a guardian angel. Another one, when he was playing Cupid, with all respect to Manang Lisa here, I was 13 or maybe 14, and Manong Bebo has this girlfriend somewhere beyond Libuan, and knowing Bebo, you know, he's always concerned, and he says, "Well, why don't you come with me?" I said, "No, that's your girlfriend." He said, "But she has a younger sister." I said, "Okay." And he fixed that for me. So without more stories, there were Manong Bebo and I and that girl and that little girl too. But he was a Cupid. He is a matchmaker at the same time, besides all these things that you've been saying about being a fisherman. He's the best guy you would like to go fishing with. With or without fish, you know, he always crack jokes. And he always says, the worst day fishing is always the best day than working at work or being at work. And I said, yeah, I think so too. But anyway, that's the many faces of Manong Bebo. And he always is very concerned with his younger brothers and sisters. And as Richie said, Suroy Suroy, yes, we call it here, he always goes out of town. Not because he doesn't like to be around us, but he's an adventurer. But whenever he comes home, he comes back, he always has something for us. Little things, little talking things. I always end up with getting a brand new short pants, you know, from him. And to me, that was very good. So I think I have to end this with a prayer. Shall we rise, please? Our omnipotent, omniscient, and omnipresent Father God, Lord in heaven, thank you so much, Lord, for your grace. We worship and praise you, Lord. Honor and glory is thine. And we cannot thank you enough, Lord, for so much blessing that this family received from you. First of all, Lord, we thank you for so much life that you have given to my brother Bibot, which he gracefully and joyfully shared with everyone, his loved ones, family, and friends. Thank you so much, Lord, for your all merciful ways, for your presence in our family's life. And we cannot thank you enough, Lord, for being so faithful in your promises to us. And Lord, we pray today, with all us living and still alive, we pray that you will help us, Lord, to be firm, to be steadfast on the truth and the faith that we have in you, so that we that are alive will see again those departed ones that has gone before us on that resurrection morning. In closing, Lord, we'd like to ask you for your troubling mercy for each one of us here this afternoon as we parted our ways, as we part our ways. May your presence, Lord, be to each one of us that would guide us and lead us as we go home. Thank you so much, Lord, for hearing and answering all our prayers. All this we ask in the dear name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. I think this portion would be for the next hour and a half would be the viewing session. This would be the last viewing. We won't have any more viewing on the funeral and burial day on Thursday. So this is it. This would be your chance to see for the last time Manong Bibot.
I can't remember when you weren't there, when I didn't care for anyone but you. I swear we've been through everything there is. Can't imagine anything we've missed. Can't imagine anything the two of us can't do. Through the years, you've never let me down. You've turned my life around. The sweetest days I found with you. Through the years, I've never been afraid. I've loved the life we've made, and I'm so glad I stayed right here with you. I can't remember what I used to do, who I trusted, who I listened to before. I swear you've taught me everything I know. Can't imagine needing someone so, but through the years it seems to me I need you more and more. Through the years, through all the good and bad, I know how much we had. I've always been so glad to be with you. Through the years, it's better every day. You've kissed my tears away. As long as it's okay, I'll stay with you through the years. Through the years when everything went wrong, together we were strong. I know that I belong right here with you. Through the years, I never by loving you through the
see.
There will be peace in
shall be led by a child, and I'll be changed, changed from this creature that I am. Oh, yes. There will be peace in the valley for me someday. There will be peace in the valley for me. Oh Lord, I pray. There'll be no sadness,
no
sorrow,
oh my Lord, and no trouble.
Trouble I see.
There will be peace in the valley for me, for me.
Rock of ages, cleft for me, let me hide myself in thee. Let the water and the blood from thy wounded side which flow be of sin the double cure. Save from wrath and make me pure. Let me hide myself in thee. In my hand, no price I bring, simply to thy cross I cling. While I draw this fleeting breath, when my eyes shall close in death, Lord, when I rise to worlds unknown and behold thee on thy throne, Rock of ages, cleft for me, let me hide myself in thee. Let me hide myself in thee.
Looks the same as I step down on the train, and there to meet me is my mama and my papa. Down the road I look, and there runs Mary, hair of gold and looks like cherries. It's good to touch the green grass of home. Yes, and they'll all come to meet me, arms reaching, smiling sweetly. Oh, it's good to touch the green grass of home. The old house is still standing, though the paint is cracked and dry. And there's that old tree that I used to play on. Yeah, and I ain't
sweet Mary, hair of gold and like cherries.
I can't remember when you weren't there, when I didn't care for anyone but you. I swear we've been through everything there is. Can't imagine anything we've missed. Can't imagine anything the two of us can't do. Through the years, you've never let me down. You've turned my life around. The sweetest days I found with you. Through the years, I've never been afraid. I've loved the life we've made, and I'm so glad I stayed right here with you through the years. I can't remember what I used to do, who I trusted, who I listened to before. I swear you've taught me everything I know. Can't imagine needing someone so. But through the years it seems to me I need you more and more. Through the years, through all the good and bad, I know how much we had. I've always been so glad to be with you. Through the better every day. You've kissed my tears away. As long as it's okay, I'll stay with you through the years. Through the years when everything went wrong, together I know that I belong right here with you. Through the years, I never had a doubt. We'd always work things out. I've learned what life's about by loving you through the
Hello, hello.
We forgot to announce that there is going to be some snacks and beverages downstairs, so if you guys want to help yourself, you can make your way downstairs. Thank you all for coming.
While I draw this leading breath, when my eyes shall close in death, Lord, when I rise to worlds unknown and behold thee on thy throne, Rock of Ages, left for me, let me hide myself in thee. Let me hide myself.
I stepped down on the train, and that will meet me is my mama and my papa. Down the road I look, and there runs Mary, hair of gold and lips like cherries. It's good to touch the green, green grass of home. Yes, and they'll all come to meet me, arms reaching, smiling sweetly. Oh, it's good to touch the green, green grass of home. The old house is still standing, though the paint is cracked and dry. And there's that old oak